Assembly. I am Keely Whitman, and I, along with the other Year 11 student leaders, Abby Taylor, Daniel Castle, Megan Castle, Gemma Delaney, and Leah Ferguson, will be your MCs for today's ceremony. A recording of this assembly will be shared later today on the school Facebook page, and we welcome all those watching. We wish you could be here in person commemorating this special milestone. I would now like to invite Year 12 student Tay Crane to the stage to deliver an acknowledgement of country.
Good morning, everyone. I would like to pay my respects to the Wurundjeri people and their elders, both past, present, and future.
Thank you, Tay. Please stand for the national anthem, which will be performed by Year 12 student Daisy James.
Acknowledging the past and present traditional custodians of this land on which we are meeting, the Wurundjeri and Wobbly people. It is a privilege to be standing on country. I acknowledge the contributions of Aboriginal Australians and not Aboriginal Australians to the education of all children and people in this country we all live in and share together. I welcome all of those in the hall today to Year 12's final assembly. Staff, Year 11, the siblings of Year 12, and of course, all of Year 12 who are graduating today. For the second consecutive year, we celebrate your final assembly without parents and without the rest of the school. It's a shame we have these restrictions, but without them, we may not have had an assembly at all. So what are the messages I want to leave with you on this final day? Firstly, on behalf of Tumut High School, I want to sincerely congratulate you, your parents, families, carers, and teachers for collectively creating the environment for you to successfully navigate 13 years of schooling. Today is a significant milestone, and you should take the time to reflect and understand you have accomplished something significant. It is important to realise that although there have been others before you that have achieved the same, they haven't had to deal with the diversity of challenges that you have encountered over your HSC years. While the word unprecedented has likely been overused in your last 2 years of schooling, it continues to be appropriate for the period of disruption that you guys have experienced. Coming off the back of the worst bushfire season we've experienced, we've been confronted with COVID-19 and the unique challenges it created for learning and teaching in our school. Once in a generation, an event happens which is so profound that leads to sweeping changes across the way we live our lives and the way our communities and society are structured. At this time, in these moments, much is being questioned and much will impact on you in the years to come. So what may you take away from your schooling into the future? I would imagine few of you realise there are key vision statements which drive teaching and learning in our school. Key statements identified by teachers which they believe drive why they teach. I would like to refer to these in highlighting what could be some guiding principles and how you can contribute to a future world which is better. Tumut High School aims to foster creative and critical thinking. Recent times have shown how easily misinformation has both governed and controlled so many of us. The outbreak of COVID-19 has been accompanied by what the World Health Organization has described as a massive infodemic. Fake news covering all aspects of the pandemic have spread rapidly through social media, creating confusion and disinformation. Peddling of fake cures such as gargling with lemon or salt water and injecting yourself with bleach, to false conspiracy theories stating the virus was bioengineered in a lab in Wuhan, or that the 5G cellular network is causing the symptoms of COVID-19, are just some examples of COVID-19 misinformation. We are hopefully, it is the critical thinking skills that you now possess or continue to develop which will enable you to easily cut through what is fact and what is fiction. So the real issues we face today, such as inequality, climate change, land degradation, can be more readily resolved. Tumut High School supports the social and emotional development of resilient and responsible individuals. The pandemic has contributed to an increase in younger people experiencing mental health concerns. However, hopefully you leave the school that little bit more stoic and have a better understanding that we should only worry about the things we can control. And that with this control comes greater mental stability, enabling you to be supportive of those around you. Finally, Tumut High School aims to provide an inclusive learning environment for all. Diversity, equity and inclusion have always had important implications for communities. The pandemic is shining a new light on these issues. COVID-19 has meant a new level of focus on how the pandemic is disproportionately impacting disadvantaged groups. Attending a public school has meant you have been part of the most inclusive education system in New South Wales. If you leave knowing that without inclusivity there is no equality, then you leave ready to combat the disadvantage created by the pandemic. You leaving today for the final time will be your final memories of school life. You will leave with many memories. Memories that you share with your friends, family and teachers. Memories help define us. They connect us. They remind us. Like no other year before you, you will always be connected by your school experience. As a cohort group, you have left a very positive impression on so many people. The comments made to me regarding you as a group have highlighted how tight and supportive of a group you are. Hopefully, that remains for many years to come. Farewell, Year 12. Good luck to those doing their final exams, and good luck to you all as you begin the next chapter of your lives. Farewell, Year 12.
Thank you, Mr. Dixon. Mr. Van Stekelenborg will now deliver the Year 12 Advisors' Address.
All right, I'll point out that as of this morning I've developed hay fever, and being really close to these flowers could affect me. Just bear that in mind. All right, mood's not good. Recess is next. And here is the speech I don't want to make. For a while I thought about choosing my words carefully to avoid any emotional triggers, but that wouldn't really be honest of me. And since when do I not tell it like it is? So let's tell it like it is. In 2015, I decided to have another go at being a year advisor. While I'm not much of a people person, I figured I'd try to connect with another group of students. As such, we started 2016 with 115 students, and I began my year advisor journey for a second time. As part of this journey over the past 6.5 years, we became a bit like a family. You guys gave me something to focus on and something to care about. Because that's what being a year advisor is all about. Looking after and caring for students. Giving them opportunities and experiences that they may not have otherwise had, and helping them to connect with each other and the broader school community. As part of our family, we've had plenty of opportunities over the past 6 years. Opportunities to travel to Wagga over the years for the positive level excursions, getting to know each other at the Year 7 camp, travelling to various places for ALP, going to Tathra, going to our camp at Goobra, going to Central, making snow angels on Payne, if anyone remembers those, and spending time together in Canberra for our Year 10 camp. Over that time, I've got to know a lot of you. I've got to connect with a lot of you. I've watched you grow up and mature as you've had to deal with the hardships of the past 2 years and step up and to help in the various roles I may have needed you to fill. I've tried to be there to open as many doors for you as I have been able to help whenever I could, to advise, to support. Indeed, in 2018 and 2021, it was largely the connection that I had with you that ensured that I continued in the teaching profession. So you do mean a lot. Being part of a year group and seeing them through their schooling is a very special thing. As I said, almost like a family. Although this proved difficult in the early years, when I had to compete with Coleman during ALP, and Grace Denny would describe her as the caring mother, and at that particular point, I was described as the embarrassing father. I'm not sure I've changed much since then. But the family is about to be broken up. and about to go in its own separate ways, as you should. You guys have come so far. You have your own hopes and your own dreams and your own connections to make in the outside world. You've got so much potential that I think we're going to be a hard year group to actually follow. At the moment, I'm kind of feeling, it's interesting, I've lost the hay fever too, so you're right, Mr. Taylor. I don't know, there's a couple more triggers at the end, so we'll see. This is one of them. At the moment, I'm kind of feeling like I normally do after Central. For 15 days, for 24 hours a day, a group is thrown together and they share so many experiences. Sometimes they're noisy, sometimes they get into trouble, but they share the connection of being together for those 15 days. Often during the trip, I'm stressed, I'm tired, I'm angry, and I say, never again. But as soon as I get home and I return to being alone, to the peace and quiet of the flat, I immediately miss the noise. I miss having the people around to care for. And that's the feeling I've been struggling with since trying to write this speech. Putting together the yearbook, though, looking back at all the amazing opportunities and experiences we've had together, means that what we do have is lots of memories. Memories of you as fresh-faced primary school students, memories of probably my favourite one, our classic water fight session down at the bull paddock, if you guys remember that one, that was fun. To memories of some of you in the past day or two wearing dresses and wigs. Thanks, Cade. Lots of memories. So, as you move forward into the world, outside of school, to make memories of your own, without your year advisor. Always remember that the year advisor label actually just changes to life advisor when you leave. Because as I said during COVID, you're never going to truly be alone. Because I am not likely to stop caring about most of you. So, all the best for your future endeavours. Remember, the scones are not burnt until I tell you that they're burnt. And even though some of you struggled to shout out or to actually get a good memory of your past 7 years for the yearbook, remember that the past 7 years is something that I'm proud of and I'm proud of you. So hopefully you are at the very least proud of what you have become as well. Mr. V Lecture, over.
I invite school captains Leona Smithson and Andy Dodds to deliver a farewell address on behalf of Year 12. Well, I'm going to start off today's speech the same way we've written speeches since primary school. Good morning, Mr. Dixon, teachers, students, and my fellow Year 12 graduates of 2021. What a bittersweet day it is for us all. We've finally finished a chapter in our lives that we all thought was going to be a never-ending story, school. I still remember starting my first day of Year 7 here, looking at all the Year 12s, thinking the day I'd become one would never arrive. But it did, and just like that, it's all over. I definitely remember showing up here and not knowing where any classrooms were. You'd think by now we would all know the school inside out, including how to walk up and down stairs. But Molly Davies, you proved me wrong. Falling down those stairs with those bright pink bike shorts on will always be a memory. Some of us are leaving with great plans to travel and see the world, and some of us are just glad it's all over and have no plans just yet. Either way, I know you will all do great things in the future, whatever it is you choose to do. But today, we're not here to talk all about the future. Today, we're here to say farewell and thank you to every person and to every experience that has influenced us and assisted us in getting to our final destination. Today, graduation. Today, we say goodbye to our teachers, the ones who pushed us to reach our full potential, supported us, were like parents to us, and the ones that will forever have an impact in our lives. I'd like to say a huge thank you to them all.
I know I wasn't the easiest student, and I know I wasn't the only one too. BT, you've only taught our PE class for a year, but by the colour of your hair, it probably feels like a lifetime to you. And you're welcome. Thank you, Ibiwi, for the birthday brownies. They were the best, and I did promise you a shout out for them the first time you made them for us. I could be here all day thanking every individual teacher for everything you have all done, but unfortunately we don't have that time, as we have a fundraiser to participate in, a tribute to one of the best teachers there was, Lopez. We are now saying goodbye to the normal that was for the past 6 years, and we say goodbye to the memories and experiences that we have created. We say goodbye, but we won't forget. Tay, the first day you showed up rapping the lyrics of your music, I never thought I'd see you in makeup and a dress. And all those bus trips and excursions this school organised will never be forgotten. Thank you to Rose, always needing a toilet stop every 10 minutes. Pretty sure it added at least half an hour to every trip. I'd like to say a huge thank you to you guys right here. Our U group has grown and shrunk in numbers through the years, but each year we become more unified and have gone from acquaintances to friends, and some friends have become like family. We've all changed as the years have gone on. Some changes were very well needed, such as a couple of the boys' haircuts. Cade, it is good to see the rat's tail didn't make it to year 12. And teachers, another thank you for your patience during the completion of year 9. I know it's the worst year. We think we're too cool for school and the attitudes are at maximum. And last but not least, a big shout out to V-Man. Thank you for everything. I know we didn't say it often or enough, but we are so grateful for everything you've done for our year group, organising the excursions and activities and making sure we never missed out and always had fun. We couldn't have had a better experience at Tumut High School without you, sir. So, congratulations, class of 2021. We have officially graduated from what parents like to call the easiest part of our lives, and it is time we step up into the real world and become adults. I hope you all go far in life, achieving everything you want and more, and I wish you all the best in this new chapter that you're about to write. Thank you and good luck.
Thank you, Liana. Tumut High School. No place you'd rather be, right? But seriously, think about it. Where else would you have been able to see your best friends every day? Where else could you have amazing conversations with a highly relatable set of teachers? Where else could you have competed in whatever sport or activity you want? The answer is that there is nowhere else that could have provided the memorable high school experience that we got here at Tumut High School. A warm good morning to staff, Year 11 and siblings. And to my peers, welcome. Welcome to what is both the end and the beginning. The end of one's schooling career is a huge milestone, one that I hope every one of you takes the time to acknowledge and celebrate individually. It's been a grand journey. We've had the opportunity to forge new friendships from the first day and again in Year 11 when the new kids arrived, embedding themselves as part of our crazy yet charming year group. Some members of our group vanished, yet somehow not quite as quickly as Kong and Kate's possessions in a classroom. But after all this time, we still remain. We've been through some tough times. We survived one of the most disrupted years of schooling in existence, battled through several tell them from me surveys, and avoided trumpet attacks from Harry. Amongst all this madness, there was happiness and hope. Hope for the future and for a new beginning. I know some of you are injecting yourselves directly into the workforce, using what you have learnt here to make a difference, both locally and abroad. I know a lot of us are going to uni around the country as well. Tumut High has helped us realise our strengths and our passions. It's now time to take that with us into the real world. Our experiences here will always be a part of us. I'm honoured to be a part of this O3 clan. After all, it's the people who make school as memorable as it is. It's hard to say goodbye to y'all. So to my peers, my friends, I wish you all the best of luck in whatever path you take. May you be able to reflect on your time here together with the fondest of memories. You're all great people, and any workforce or establishment would be super lucky to have you on board. Being a school captain was made much more enjoyable this year by my other co-captains and friends, Liana, Harry and Janae. We really did make a great team, filling in for each other at every occasion, being at an SRC meeting or greeting with a VIP. Thank you for all your help, guys. You made the role better than I could have ever imagined. I'd also like to extend a sincere appreciation to the staff of Tumut High School. You've helped us learn and belong in a great school environment, managing to go above and beyond to give us the best experience and memories as possible as a year group. From awesome excursions to Y Wednesday, we have created memories that will remain with us forever. Your ongoing enthusiasm has helped us to stay motivated right till the end, making you a big part of us being able to stand here today at graduation. I'd like to make a special mention to Ms. Stroud and Ms. Sturt for their significant contributions to help make Year 12 a bit more manageable. And now is as good a time as any to say, on behalf of the students at Tumut High School, to all the teachers, Happy World Teachers Day. We would like to thank you so much, and we're happy to be sharing our morning tea with you this morning as well. Shout out to all the siblings present today, as well as all the parents who I'm sure will enjoy watching the recording to be released shortly after the conclusion of this assembly. You're all a huge part of us being able to reach this milestone today, and we are super grateful that you can spectate this moment. To Year 11, look guys, it's understandable if you can't quite reach the standard that we've set as a year group, but jokes aside though, definitely give Year 12 your best shot, and it's good to know that the school is in very capable hands. And it's great to have you guys here today to attend this as well. Finally, to our awesome year advisor, Mr. V. If there was only one of the countless speeches you've heard from me over the years that I want you to remember, it's this one. Because you need to know how much you mean to our year group. Having someone in our corner from day one has given us the reassurance we needed to excel at school. It's no secret that you're an idol to every one of us. And who knows, maybe one day, thanks to you, I might actually be able to understand the alphabet correctly. Thank you, Mr. V. To further express our gratitude to Mr. V, I'll shortly be handing over to Harry and Janae. Congratulations, class of 2021. Relax, enjoy, and get excited for the things ahead. Thank you.
Dean Beeman, Mr. V, the man in charge. Since you're a renowned English teacher and all-round funny guy,
we just wanted to add on to any of the other speeches, but with a little pizzazz in Hazanay style.
Since Year 7, the only thing we know you love more than your beloved year group, full of highly motivated and serious students, is KFC.
You never fail to mention how much you love us and a bucket of chicken.
So as our gift to you, we've got you what you've always wanted us to get you, a bucket of KFC.
Hope that's what.
But before we hand this over, we would first like to remind you of the many memories you've cherished with us and why we all appreciate you very much.
I think I speak on behalf of everyone when I say the funniest thing we will remember you for is belly flopping like a duck to water.
Let's not forget your indomitable debating and unfaltering reminders why you are right. Skills.
Invaluable yet insufferable sense of humour.
Passion for soft cross in the blistering sun, which we got something for.
Don't put it on your hair, we've got our hats inside.
Love a station.
And also love of stationery.
Especially to remind us that you can write well with your left hand. Anyway, I think we've droned on long enough.
I think so, Harry.
On behalf of all of Year 12,
we extend the warmest of thank yous.
It's been an amazing 6 years, and I think we've all appreciated your unwavering, encouraging, and overly supportive mentor.
Thank you, Mr. B. Mr. B.
Liana, Harry, and Janae. Daisy James and Madison Hibbert will now entertain us with the musical item.
Thank you.
Year 12 will now be presented with their graduation portfolio. Students will also be receiving awards that would normally be presented at our annual presentation evening, which is not able to proceed this year. I invite Mr. Dixon and Mr. V back to the stage to make these presentations.
Montana Ambrose, All-Rounder for Community and Family Studies and Food Technology, Encouragement Award for English Standard, Geography and Mathematics Standard 2, High Academic Achievement and Values Award. Elijah Baker, All-Rounder Award for Chemistry, Encouragement Award for Biology and Geography, High Academic Achievement. Jade Bell Chambers, All-Rounder Award for Agriculture. Harry Botero, ADF 2021 Future Innovators Award, Citizen Blue Student Representative Council 2020 to 2021, Snowy Hydro Outstanding Academic Excellence Award, High Academic Achievement Values Award, Aurora College Academic Achievement for Chemistry, Aurora College Academic Excellence for Science Extension, Aurora College First in Course for Mathematics Extension 2 and Physics, Tom Boxall, Encouragement Award for English Studies. Lara Boyd, All-Rounder Award for Sports, Lifestyle and Recreation. Encouragement Award for Work Studies. Cassie Brennan. Mackenzie Clear, Encouragement Award for Community and Family Studies and Geography. Tanika Coles, Encouragement Award for Business Studies. Kaylee Collins, All-Rounder Award for Mathematics Standard 2, Encouragement Award for English Standard, Geography, Modern History and High Academic Achievement. Sinate Crane, Certificate of Congratulations, School-Based Traineeship in Certificate 3 Retail. Caitlin Crawford, Snowy Hydro Outstanding Academic Excellence Award, All-Rounder Award for Ancient History, Biology, English Advanced, Mathematics Advanced and Modern History, Encouragement Award for English Extension 1, High Academic Achievement and Values Award. Cameron Creedy. Molly Curl, Encouragement Award for English Standard. Xavier Curtis. Molly Davies, Encouragement Award for Visual Arts, Values Award. And Annabelle Dean, Encouragement Award for Hospitality.
Emma Dean, Andrew Dodds, ADF 2021 Longtan Youth Leadership and Teamwork Award. Ample All-Rounder Award, Citizenship Blue Citation, Student Representative Council 2016 to 2021, Sporting Blue Citation, Riverina Swimming Representation 2016 to 2021, Encouragement Award for Biology, Chemistry, Geography and Mathematics Advance, High Academic Achievement, Values Award, Sporting Award, Open Boys Basketball. Angel Dubois. James Duncan, Sporting Blue, Riverina Cross Country Representation 2018 and 2021, Encouragement Award for Mathematics Standard 2 and Music, Values Award, Southern Slopes Cross Country Age Champion. Nerilee Eastlake, All-Rounder Award for Drama. Annie Eccleston. Chloe Ferguson, Reuben F. Scarf Award, Certificate of Achievement Chinese Beginners, Encouragement Award for Community and Family Studies, English Advanced, Legal Studies and Mathematics Standard 2. Seth Ferguson. Casey Field, Encouragement Award for English Studies and Food Technology. Monique Fisher, All-Rounder Award for Hospitality, Encouragement Award for Food Technology and Sports Lifestyle and Recreation. Alyssa Giddings. Lily Giddings, Encouragement Award for English Standard, Food Technology and Legal Studies. Oliver Gilbert. Ethan Gilchrist. Mackenzie Glynn. Amelia Hassett, Sporting Blue, Riverina Basketball and Netball Representation 2020 to 2021, Encouragement Award for Hospitality.
Shay Hayes, All-Rounder Award for Mathematics Standard 1, Encouragement Award for Visual Arts. Lane Hayes. Jamie Hibbins, Tumut High School Athletics Age Champion. Thomas Hibbins, Leadership Award, Encouragement Award for Ancient History, Business Studies, Drama, English Standard and Mathematics Standard 2. Madison Hibbert, Citizenship Blue, Citation for School and Community Service, Snowy Hydro Outstanding Academic Excellence Award, All-Rounder Award for English Extension 1, English Extension 2, Music and Visual Arts, Encouragement Award for English Advanced and Mathematics Standard 2, High Academic Achievement Award and Values Award. Daisy James, Citizenship Blue for School and Community Service, Encouragement Award for Drama and Music and Values Award. Catherine Jeffrey. Grace King. Tavia King, Encouragement Award for English Studies. Cade Knight, Hall of Fame Citation, 2021 Gold, Silver and Bronze Medalist at Tumut High School CHS State Swimming Championships. Sporting Blue Citation, Riverina Swimming Representative, 2016 to 2021. Encouragement Award for Business Studies. Southern Slopes Swimming Age Champion, Tumut High School Swimming Age Champion, Tumut High School Record Breaker, 50 metres and 100 metres backstroke, oh no, breaststroke, 50 metres and 100 metre butterfly, and 100 metre freestyle. Caleb McNamara Boyd. Emily Meady, Encouragement Award for Business Studies and Music, and Tumut High School's runner-up swimming age champion. Tatenda Mwandi, Encouragement Award for Ancient History, Business Studies, English Standard and Legal Studies. Sarah Oriel, Isabella Pappas Encouragement Award for English Standard, Legal Studies, Mathematics Advanced and Mathematics Extension. Ethan Parker All-Rounder Award for Business Studies, Encouragement Award for Mathematics Advanced and Mathematics Extension. And Phoebe Pierce All-Rounder Award for English Standard, Legal Studies and PE, Encouragement Award for Biology and Modern History, High Academic Achievement and Values Award. Rose Petfield, All-Rounder Award for Geography, Encouragement Award for Biology and English Standard, and Encouragement Award for PDHP and a Values Award. Jalen Proud, Jack is away. Maddie Reinders, Encouragement Award for Biology, Mathematics Advanced and PDHP and a Values Award. Luana Russell. Reese Russell. Thomas Salmon. Jordan Sambrook, All-Around Award for Mathematics Extension, Encouragement Award for Biology, Geography and Mathematics Advanced. Frederick Schoenfeld. Duncan Smallwood, Hall of Fame Silver Medalist at 2021 New South Wales CHS State Swimming Championships, Sporting Blue Citation Riverina Swimming Representative 2016 to 2021, Tumut High School Runner-Up at Swimming Age Champion. Tegan Smith, All-Rounder Award for History Extension, Encouragement Award for English Advanced, English Extension 1, Geography and Modern History, High Academic Achievement and a Values Award. Liana Smithson, Citizen Blue Citation Student Representative Council 2019 to 2021, Sporting Blue and Riverina School Sports Certificate of Achievement for Riverina, Hockey Representative 2019 to 2021, Encouragement Award for Biology, Mathematics Standard 2 and PDHP and a Values Award. Jordan Thomas. Leith Turner, Encouragement Award for Community and Family Studies, English Advanced and Modern History. Janae Vandermeer, Citizen Blue Citation Student Representative Council 2018 to 2021, Encouragement Award for Drama and a Values Award. Ari Waller. Charlotte White, Encouragement Award for Food Tech and Music and a Values Award. Hayley Young, All-Rounder Award for English Studies and Work Studies, Encouragement Award for Sports, Lifestyle and Recreation.
Please join me in congratulating Year 12. We will now have the 2021 school captains and vice captains announce the 2022 school leaders. So can I please have Liana, Andy, Harry and Janae up onto the stage.
Delaney.
And joining her as the other school captain for 2022 is Daniel Castle.
The girls vice captain of 2022, Keely Whitman.
The other vice captain for 2022 is Abby Taylor.
That brings the formalities for the 2021 graduation assembly to a conclusion. Please join me in wishing Year 12 all the best for the future.